word everywhere in your day-to-day life, engine of the two-wheeler, engine of the four-wheeler. But as being a mechanical engineer, it is very essential to know the detailed things about this internal combustion engine. Internal combustion engine is having the very vast range of applications. If you see its application, it has the application in various fields. If you see its application, then the first field of application of the engine is automobile sector. So in case of the automobile, as we know, all kind of vehicles, that may be the two-wheeler, three-wheeler, four-wheeler, bus, truck, even the railway, which are used for transportation purpose, almost 98% of vehicles are powered by the engine. 2% of vehicles are powered by the battery, that is electrical vehicles. That is one of the emerging sector, you know. But still, we are not getting the performance as super as the engine-powered vehicle by battery-powered vehicles. So that still, in majority of the vehicles, the engines are used to drive the vehicles. Again, in that case, all kind of vehicles we can consider for automobile. The second is field of agriculture. If you see the agriculture field, again the engines are used most commonly in various kind of machines, in various kind of equipments which are useful for doing the work, agriculture work. For example, if you see the machines used in the field of agriculture as a thresher. Thresher machine is one of the machines which is used for threshing of the various crops like millets, maize, safflower. So, like this wheat, we can thresh by using the thresher machine. And this thresher machine is powered by the engine. Again, if you see the harvester. The harvester is again one of the machines which is powered by engine, which is used for harvesting the various kind of crops like wheat, safflower, again sugarcane harvesting. So again, if you see for spraying pesticides on the crops, we are using the spray pump. In earlier days, these spray pumps were hand spray pump. Nowadays, these spray pumps are used, or these are powered by the engines. So again, the spray pump. So like this, various excavator is there, bulldozer is there, tractor is there, which are used for various purpose of the agriculture work, which are powered by engine itself. So again, wherever the electricity is not easily available, in that case, the engines are used for pumping the water from well, from river, canal, etc. Now again, another field of application of this engine, if you see the aviation sector, in case of the aviation sector, aeroplanes, helicopter, these are powered by the engine. So again, if you see the next field of application is in case of the defense. Marine field, the engines are used in the ship. again for tourism purpose, whatever the boats are used, those boats are powered by the engine. Industrial applications are also there, where the engines are used in various equipments and in the machines. As we know that if you consider the machines used for construction purpose, that may be the building construction, road construction or the dam construction. The machines like transit mixer, 10x7 mixer, reversible mixer, tower hoist, all these are powered by engines. So that again in case of the power generation, inside of the power generation, the generators are powered by engine itself. So the small generators are used at various industries. Wherever there is electricity is not available, then it is made available through the generator. All these generators are powered by engine itself. So that by seeing towards the field of application of the engine, engines are most commonly used in various areas. So it is very essential for us to study the detailed construction, working principle and its auxiliary systems required on the engine for its satisfactory working. So that it is very essential to know about the internal combustion engine. Now we will see what is meant by engine. So how you are going to define the engine in technical language? So if you want to define the engine, what is meant by engine? In simple language, engine can be defined as it is a device which can be used to convert one form of energy into another. It has the moving parts and it uses the converted energy to do the useful type of work. For example, in case of the engine, it converts one form of energy to another. As we know that energy is available in various forms, chemical energy, electrical energy, thermal energy, but to do the particular type of work, one form of energy is not suitable. Before using the energy, it is required to convert this energy in the desired form and later on use it. For that purpose, the device which is used to convert one form of energy to another form is known as engine. So it converts one form of energy to another. Simply, it is energy conversion device. Of course, it is having the moving parts. And the third thing important related to the engine is the converted energy it is utilized to do the particular type of work. For example, the human body itself is one kind of engine. Because what happens in our body, we are taking food as an intake. The food consists of energy in the form of chemical energy. Whenever we will eat the food, it will get digested and energy is converted into other form. And that energy we are utilizing to run, to walk, to speak, to exercise, whatever it may. So it is the best example of engine. So it is one kind of engines. But the engines are generally known as the heat engines. What heat engine? Engines are generally known as heat engines. Because in actual internal combustion engine, the chemical energy of the fuel is converted into heat energy by combustion process, and further this heat energy is converted into mechanical work. So the engines are generally known as heat engines. So in heat engine, it converts chemical energy of the fuel, chemical energy to heat energy energy to mechanical work. So generally engines are known as heat engines. So here in this case we are using fuel like petrol, diesel, kerosene or any gaseous fuel, CNG, LPG. All these fuels are having the energy in the form of chemical energy. When we are going to burn this fuel in the combustion chamber of the internal combustion engine, it liberates heat. The chemical energy is converted into heat energy. Further, this heat energy is utilized to drive the piston. So the heat energy is converted into mechanical work, and that is used to do the particular type of work. So these are known as heat engines. Now, the second word in the title of this subject is combustion. So what is mean by combustion? So in general, combustion is nothing but one kind of burning. It is the process of burning. That may be the any kind of fuel, that may be the wood, that may be the paper. So whenever you want to burn, that is nothing but one kind of combustion. So in technical language, combustion can be defined as it is a chemical reaction in which the certain elements of the fuel like hydrogen, carbon reacts with oxygen and liberates heat and light energy. During the combustion process, you can say the combustion, it is the chemical reaction. It is the chemical reaction. In this case, the certain elements of the fuel like hydrogen, H2 or carbon, these are combined with oxygen, O2, and due to this chemical reaction, the heat and light energy are liberated. That is, it liberates heat and light energy. So in this case, in the engine is considered, we are not going to utilize the light energy for any purpose, but the heat energy generated due to the combustion process we are going to utilize for drive the piston. So that is nothing but simply the combustion. To carry out the combustion, as we know that we require the three things. Those are nothing but what? Elements of fire type. So in that case, the first thing, we require the fuel to produce the combustion. Second thing, we require the heat to initiate the ignition. And third thing, we require the oxygen. If any one of the elements is not present, then it is not possible to produce the combustion. So during the combustion process, certain elements from the fuel, they are combined with oxygen and liberates heat and light energy. That is nothing but combustion. So again, the heat engine is broadly classified in two categories. We will see the category of the heat engine. Now the heat engine . These are broadly classified in two categories. One is external combustion engine. External combustion engine. And second one is internal combustion engine. Now, these two categories, based upon the fundamental difference between these two, is that in case of the external combustion outside the engine cylinder. And the products of combustion are not utilized for driving the piston or drive the engine. So main thing is that in case of the external combustion engine, these are the engines in which combustion takes place outside the engine cylinder, and products of combustion is known as a working fluid. Combustion takes place outside and working fluid is other than combustion products, and working fluid is not combustion products. Outside combustion. These are the two important things related to the external combustion engine. Whenever we will see it is an external combustion engine, in that case, the combustion is totally outside the engine and products of combustion are directly escaped to the atmosphere. These are not utilized to drive the piston. So, for example, this external combustion engine is the steam turbine. All these are utilized to drive the piston. These gases force will The example of this one is SI engine. Now, petrol engine is one of the example of internal combustion engine. So, whenever if you see difference in these two kind of engines, external combustion, internal combustion, as per their name, in case of the external combustion engine, combustion takes place outside the engine. In case of the internal combustion engine, combustion takes place inside the engine. This is one of the point. Next thing, working media or the working fluid used in the external combustion engine is not the products of combustion. And other hand, in case of the internal combustion engine, the products of combustion are utilized as a working fluid. Again, if you see, the external combustion engines are required the large space as it is having the many number of auxiliary equipments like boiler, condenser, feed pump, certain auxiliary systems it will require. So it is required the larger space. And if you see the internal combustion engine, it is the compact one. The space required is very less. And the other thing, if you see the efficiency of this both kind of engines, the efficiency of external combustion engine is less due to the many components. There is very not effectively the heat is transferred in the mechanical work due to the large number of components in the engine system. So the efficiency of internal combustion engine is more as compared to the external combustion engines. So due to this certain advantages of internal combustion engine, it is light in weight, it is compact, its efficiency is more, and again it is not required the auxiliary systems like boiler, condenser or other economizer, heat pump. So it is most commonly used everywhere rather than the external combustion engine. Again, one of the important thing, internal combustion engine is easily portable, but external combustion engine is not portable. We cannot take it from one place to another place as far as external combustion engine is concerned, but we can take the internal combustion engine wherever we require. We can mount it in the vehicle or for any other purpose, we can take it to other places whenever we will require it. So these are the major difference between these two category of the heat engine.